We have a problem with our armor in 1.21.2 or 1.21.3, whichever you are using. Hello everyone, this is Ali Reza. Welcome to the Mentor Code Lab. In previous episode, we had updated our code into 1.21.2. If you didn't update to 1.21.3, you should do it because it was just a hotfix and it came out really fast. And honestly, it will not affect your code, so just update to that hotfix. However, at the end of the video, we assumed that everything works and I told you that you have to sit back and do a massive game test. When I was recording the video, I thought that I had covered everything because I did tweak the data gen and especially about the armor. And I came into the game, I opened the creative tab and looked at my textures and armors are there. So I thought that, okay, my JSON files are okay, my models are okay, then my items should be okay and I should have my armor. As you see, I still get the effects. However, where is my model on my character? I'm equipping a full emerald set right now, but I'm not rendering it. So what is the problem? It took me a few minutes to understand the difference. If we go into vanilla, we see that under assets, Minecraft models, we have this new folder called equipment. If we come into our generated JSON files, we see that under generated assets, our mod ID models, we don't have that equipment folder. So I thought that, okay, it should be easy fix. The model provider should have something for that equipment. So I went into generator dot, and guess what? We don't have anything related to equipment. Also, if you look into the Java docs and search for equipment in the whole fabric method calls, you won't see anything related to equipment model generation. For time being, you can do this. Open the Minecraft source, come into assets, models, equipment, copy it, and come back to your resources, not the generated one, but your own resources folder. Under assets, your mod ID models, paste it and yes, call it equipment. And here, delete everything other than maybe diamond or iron. I will keep iron. Also, notice that it is not talking about iron armor. If I open this JSON, you see that this is covering the horse armor, this is covering the humanoid, and this is covering the humanoid leggings. Let's just rename this and I will keep it with a dot back so it is not parsed with the system. However, now I want to have my own and let's call it Emerald because it is using the identifier name that we are assigning to material IDs. So Emerald. And for Emerald, right now I don't have a horse body, so I will remove that part. Also notice that before than this, we didn't get any texture missing problem. We didn't have any errors being logged about missing textures. Also, don't forget that you need to change the namespace here and the name so it will become UIO Emerald on both sections. Let's run the game and see if it works or not, because I know it won't, but I want to walk you through each step so that you learn how you can do these sort of things. Now, how did I find this equipment? Of course, I had my generated models and I thought that, okay, I'm missing a model. So what did I do? I just came to Minecraft vanilla structure and I looked into assets. Mod ID here is Minecraft models. And what do I see? Equipment. Opening the equipment, I found iron, and opening the iron, I saw, okay, now we have a humanoid and humanoid leggings here. That can be the problem. So we move forward with the same JSON file inside the same structure and let's see if that fixes the whole thing. Also, I'm looking at my log file at the same time. Let's go into the game the moment I hit F5. Okay, here we go. First of all, now I'm seeing black and purple. That's a good sign. It means that now my armor is being rendered. However, we are missing textures. Also, if I come back to my console, take a look at the top. It's yelling at me about failed to load textures. Now, this is a very good hint. Look at the directory. Textures, wow. Entity, equipment, humanoid. Okay, let's take a look at vanilla. Textures, entity, equipment. Oh, we have a humanoid and humanoid leggings now. Okay, let's take a look at humanoid iron. It's layer 0 and humanoid leggings iron, it's layer 1. So basically what did happen is that Minecraft has moved the textures around. Previously, we had them under models and armor. It was not a very good place for it, honestly. So now we should have under textures a new directory called entity, and under entity I can just copy paste it from console. You should have a new directory called equipment. Under equipment we have this humanoid, okay, and if I take a look I should have another missing texture about humanoid leggings, so I can just copy the name, and under equipment another directory called humanoid leggings. Now the emerald layer 1 goes into humanoid, and yes, Yes, remember, this is the whole texture and you can compare it with iron. This is the humanoid. However, we need to rename it and remove underline layer underline 1, keep it as emerald, and emerald layer 2 goes under humanoid leggings, and again it should be renamed to emerald alone. And hopefully this time if I run the game, I should see my emerald armor around my character. Okay, now hitting F5, and what do you know, we have our armor now. One last test, because honestly I think we have to really test this one. Let's go into the smithing table, and I want a pattern. Let me see. Yeah, silence. And I want redstone one, so redstone dust. Thank you. And also I need to move my armor out. Now I have to put down the smithing table, go into it, and what you know, my armor is already being trimmed, because if I put it on, and I saw it already on the smithing table, but you see that the trim is actually working, and now we should be able to trim our armor. Yes, our emerald is now on the chest plate trimmed, the leggings are trimmed, and the boots are trimmed. So let's put them on the character and take a look at them in game. So as you see, the armor is now trimmed and it's showing the trim properly, and already we had the effects. This is how you should fix your models right now. Basically, we can't use DataGen because apparently fabric model generator is based on what is already presented in Yarn. So we have to wait for Minecraft to add something in its own code. Then we can create these JSON files using DataGen. However, honestly, it's not a big deal. Just remember that at any time in future, if you want to add horse armor into the game with the same materials, you have to open this guy and copy this horse body from the top, paste them under the JSON files, and fix the namings there. But honestly, that shouldn't be a big deal. Right now, I finished those JSON files, so honestly, it's not a big deal. The only thing remaining is to move these layer ones into our humanoid and just rename them, and then we have to move the rest from under here into leggings, and then we can get rid of this model armor section because it's already gone. And also we need to rename these files. Now keep in mind, in recent version of Minecraft, it looks like anything that is equipable by the player should have a JSON inside that equipment model folder, because if we go down under this models equipment, you can see something like carpet or elytra. So anything that is possible for the player to put them on and equip them should have a JSON here. Also, under the textures, I really don't see any model folder anymore. It looks like horse bodies are coming here, llama body is a new thing, wings is for elytra, and this is for the wolf armor that is inside vanilla. You just have to find the correct folder structure now. You don't have any more models and armor folder. You have this entity equipment, and that is where you should put your models there.
If you like these videos, please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and turn on that bell so that when I publish a new video, you will get informed. Have fun, everyone. Bye.